conference report has done a very thought-provoking video entitled Purposeful Lambs. A link to the video can be found in the underbar. I suggest you view his video first before viewing mine, because mine will presuppose that you are largely acquainted with the material in his video. Nevertheless, I will now give a brief summary of some of the positions and concerns of his video. Conference report tells us that being purposive is not always positive. That I take to be unassailably correct. He makes references to a film that he saw about the training of suicide bombers. Among other things, conference report discusses how the training of suicide bombers is very much about the creation of purposeful persons. Conference report notes that these people feel as though they become more than themselves when they find a higher purpose. According to conference report, the irony is that individuals whose purposes we don't admire can have many of the same characteristics of the individuals whose purposes we do admire. This leads conference report to raise serious questions about purposefulness as such. According to conference report, purposiveness is oversold. It is something we should be careful of. He says that trying to ally yourself to something larger than yourself can be a dangerous activity. He doesn't know why we applaud it so much. Purpose, goals, achievements, he says, are things we should be careful of, particularly when we join forces to achieve communal goals. But there are exceptions to these concerns, conference report tells us. The problem is that there are always martyrs to these goals, he says, sacrificial lambs that are produced in pursuit of those goals. Now, I want to suggest that we can make valid and clear distinctions between purposeful individuals we should admire and purposive individuals we should not admire. But before I take up that issue, I want to briefly say something about suicide bombers. The phenomenon of the suicide bomber is a very complex phenomenon. While in all cases I do not support the use of suicidal terrorism against innocent civilians, some suicide bombers are arrayed against undeniable forces of oppression. They are resistance fighters. And then some suicide bombers are driven to their means of resistance through a kind of desperation of weaponry. They lack the kind of weaponry that is available to militaries, and they use the only means of armed resistance available to them. Then there are suicide bombers whose political goal is totalitarian, often a theocratic totalitarianism. It is this kind of suicide bomber that I will be discussing in the remainder of my video. Okay, now. Can we make valid and clear distinctions between purposeful individuals we should admire and purposeful individuals we should not admire? I think we can. I have two distinctions to proffer. One difference between the two is, as conference report said in his video, we tend to admire purposeful individuals who have purposes we agree with. And we don't admire purposeful individuals who have purposes we don't agree with. Of course, who we are in this formulation is not uniform. After all, there are those who admire jihadist suicide bombers precisely because they agree with their avowed theocratic purposes. This is not a we that I number myself among. Instead, I admire purposeful individuals who have purposes about broadening and deepening democratic participation over the forces of production and creating organs of social maintenance through free association. I think that there is an important and fairly clear distinction between purposeful individuals who try to impose some kind of rule upon people and those purposeful individuals who try to empower people to rule themselves. And while I think that we can have important differences about the means that the latter group sometimes employs to empower people to rule themselves, I also don't think that we can object to their purposes on convincing moral grounds. Another difference between the two is that we tend to admire those whose sacrifices seem to be motivated by a genuine selflessness. These individuals contrast rather starkly and obviously with those who sacrifice themselves in such a way as to aggrandize themselves. Consider the suicide bombers who blow themselves up and innocent bystanders because they believe that their act will acquire the eternal approbation of a god. These are not selfless individuals. Quite the contrary. They are endeavoring to do two things. First, they are purposefully striving to write themselves larger than what they really are by acquiring the identity of a martyr. Second, they are purposefully striving to eternalize their larger selves. Instead of being selfless, they are among the most dangerous kinds of narcissists. Thanks for your attention.